pastor hadn't been with Concordia but a week when three women from the community, it just so happens all of them were named Barbara. We call it the story of the three Barbaras. But these single mothers had nowhere to take their children after school each day. They were, again, single mothers without much for means and needed help from the church. So even though they weren't members of the church, Pastor Zook responded, childcare, how hard can that be? You know, he was right out of seminary. He still thought he knew quite a bit. And he, you know, rallied the church, rallied the community, and they created the first Concordia Child Care Center.
There was a time that when I first met him that I wasn't sure Concordia Church was still going to be there. It was a very small congregation. It's not the case anymore, and I think it's because of his persistence and passion and vision for how he could meet the needs of the community and the needs of the individual members in proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ.
The new Concordia Place now serves almost 650 children, children of all races, of all economic backgrounds, of all religious entities, not just Lutheran or Christian, and yet on a given day you might see the pastor outside of Concordia Place dressed in his clerics, greeting the moms and the dads and the children. The people who come there clearly know this is a ministry of Concordia Lutheran Church.
Above all things, I believe that Nicholas, as a man of faith, has always wanted to be and is a parish pastor, a shepherd of a flock. He is who he always wanted to be, a pastor of an urban church, making a difference in the lives of the people that he's charged to care for.
I'm totally amazed that the persistence, the vision, the insight that he provides to make sure that the project is completed. I can remember when they started on expanding into this Avondale community. I'll be honest, I was a little concerned about biting off more than they could chew. That did not stop him in one iota. He pursued it, not only through the community, but through the public officials. He was at their doorstep, I am sure, time and time again, because he believed so much in the mission of what he was doing and what the church was doing to meet the needs of the community.
He is relentless in his pursuit of the goals that he places in front of him. He's so good at melding together a variety of opinions and a variety of points of view into a consensus, and then not stopping there, not be willing to accept victory in discussion, but to take that forward and put it into action, and then to not only put it into action and manage it, but to lead it into action.
He really dreams big and has a big vision that isn't, well, how much money do we have, and then what can we do with it? It's really, what needs to be done here? And then, how do we go about getting the means to accomplish that? Frankly, that's a little, I think, scary for me and probably for most people, that you first look at, well, what are my means? And then you look at what can you do with that? And because he has this backwards way of looking at things, which sounds bad, but this backwards way of looking at things that gets us far beyond what anyone would dream.
There are mothers who are saying, we couldn't hold our family together if it weren't for Concordia Place. We have to work. And here's a safe place, but a nourishing place. Here's a place where our children are thriving, where children are being nourished. And now that program has expanded to serve seniors in the community and emerging leaders, teenage kids, coming to Concordia Place after school. It's safe, the gangs aren't there, and they're able to continue with their homework and be tutored to take computer lessons, whatever it may be, all in the name of the church.
So we talk about, you know, vision and persistence and all of these things that seem, you know, a bit heavy, but you sprinkle in Pastor's bad sense of humor with all of that, and it's been a lot of fun.
I think one of the true hallmarks of a leader is to always be in front, and Nicholas is always in front of what we are doing, never allowing others to push the rocks uphill. He's always there as someone who's willing to do it and an inspiration to the rest of us to push a little bit harder.